Often these hormones, after they have been tested prior to surgery and they are found to be deficient, these hormones are tested and they should be treated accordingly and replaced if they are deficient. And then after the surgery, these hormones are then rechecked to see if the patient still requires the hormones or not. More often than not, after the surgery, these patients continue to require these hormones. Very rarely they may come off of these hormones, but in my experience, it's usually the case where patients actually stay on these hormones for long term.